Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu, friends. Welcome back to my channel. Today we will see electromagnetic relay. As we see, some switches like this, any type, piano switch, toggle switch. Switch makes connection between any voltage to the load. It is a metal bar. Line or supply is coming here. Then this is switch. When it is on, it will connect load with line. When we will turn off, it will open the contact, so current will stop. Some switches are single pole, single throw. Some switches have double pole. Load 1, load 2. When this switch is off, it will connect line voltage to this load. When it is on, it will connect line voltage to this load and it will disconnect from here. So this lever, this arm will shift here. It is called single pole double throw. Some switches are double pole double throw. Sometimes two different lines are connected here, sometimes positive and negative voltage here. So this voltage will drive two channels. It will control two loads. One on, second off. One off, second on. The same way here. It is called common point. Normally C or common. This is normally closed point. And this is normally open point. Common two. Common 1, common 2, and it is also NC, NO. If we see this switch, it is using two path, line to load, in between there is switch, on, off. It will connect line voltage to the load, maybe line or neutral, line here. Neutral here, when it will turn on, it will connect these both lines to output side. It is double pole, single throw. So it will just only connect to one load. Single throw means one load. If we see this switch, this is common. When it is in one direction, it will connect load between these two points. When it is shifted to second side, it will connect this common to this one. Same way here, this common with this. So two different paths are here. Here we are shifting this lever manually. But if we have some mechanism that these switch points will shift electrically, that will call relay. If we see it spin out, this point, it is coming here at this point. If you see closely, this point is coming here and then it is reaching to this terminal. So it is controlling this load. Now if you see, now this point is connected here. If this arm will move here in this direction, that time this switch will shift here. Now it is open from here, closed here. Same in this side, normally it is connected with this point. When it will move to this side, it will change its points here. So current coming from this point, now it will move to this point. If it is off, it will move to this point. So it will control the load opposite to each other. If this is on, this will off. This is on, this will off. When relay is on, this will off. Now this load will turn on. So current passing from here, now moving to this point, like this. From the second side, this point, current is coming out from here. When relay will turn on, this current will come out from here and this current will come out from here. Both points are insulated. So two different channels. We can say we have this separate switch set and this separate switch set. Here is coil winding inductor that is installed on core. We know when we apply current to any coil, it will create magnetic field. When it will create magnetic field, it will pull this iron piece. This moving piece that is shifting these contacts, it is pulled back by this spring. This spring is installed here to create hammer action. So this pulling force created by this tension spring, it is making a strong connection between common point and normally closed point. So there will no sparking. Now when we will apply voltage to this coil on these two points, let's see the result. I applied voltage to the coil, it is 0.3 volt. I am increasing the voltage. I applied voltage to this coil, and if I check, it is creating electromagnet, but still it cannot pull this lever. Now I will increase more voltage. At 25 volts, it shifted the lever. It is 0.3 volt and the point are still there. There is electromagnet, but still it cannot pull this arm to this side because this spring tension is still more than the electromagnetic force. Now the points are shifted here. Now it is making connection here. Second side to this point. When it is off, it is making connection here. But it is open here. It is not making connection here. Same way here. And it is open from second side. Now the points are shifted here. This point is now closed and this is open. This is closed, this is open. So we can say we have inductor here, coil here. It will create magnetic field. It will pull these arms towards this coil. Positive, negative. When relay is connected, a flyback diode is connected across this winding, which will protect this relay from oscillation effect. When the power will disconnect it, it will make vibration effect. Sometimes there is a problem in the contacts. These contacts, because these are moving part in a relay, so it makes sparking. When it makes sparking, the contact resistance increases. At that time, it will not make good connection. If we check this point, this common point, this contact is facing exactly to the normal closed and normal open points. But this side, this point is not facing properly, so it will make sparking. It will not pass a full current because half portion of this common point is touching to this point. When it will move here, half point will touch here. So this relay, this point will make problem in the working. It will not allow to pass full current. So this is the working concept of a relay. Relay might be single pole, single throw, single pole, double throw, double pole, double throw, or multi-channel relay. I hope this video is informative. If it is good, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.